So CBC Radio 1 had a story a couple days ago about Fukushima, and it had, I think, a misleading statement. Me and many people emailed asking for them to issue a retraction. They did issue a clarification. I'm going to play that clarification right now, then I'll play the original reporting.
We want to clarify a story we brought you Thursday. That was the 10-year anniversary of the magnitude 9 earthquake and tsunami that struck Japan's northeast coast. Nearly 20,000 people died. But we want to make it clear those deaths happened as a result of the quake and tsunami, not the nuclear meltdown that followed after waves hit the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant.
So I was not the only person who wrote into the CBC about this, but I'm going to read you what I wrote. CBC Omnibudsman Jack Nagler, could CBC alert World Report listeners that this CBC statement was extremely misleading? And I include a quote of the statement.
Japan is marking 10 years since a magnitude 9 earthquake and tsunami struck the northeast coast. The waves triggered a triple meltdown at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant. Radiation spread to the surrounding communities. Nearly 20,000 people were killed in the disaster. And as Katie Starr tells us from Tokyo, the effects are still being felt today.
And then I say to Jack, CBC is saying this the very day after UNSCEAR updated their 2013 report, re-releasing it in 2021, to restate that still no discernible health impacts from radiation are expected to be seen due to the Fukushima meltdown.
Nearly 20,000 people died, but we want to make it clear those deaths happened as a result of the quake and tsunami, not the nuclear meltdown that followed after waves hit the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant.
Not once has a nuclear incident caused a death in Canada. Not once.